Yeah, that one's mine though.
Action.
This is over here. Yours is yours. One of these pretty ones.
Yeah, whichever one you want.
Action.
Hello, it's me again, and we're making homemade ice cream here today, and somebody ate my sweetened condensed milk. We ain't figured out who it is yet, and so we're going to make it old style, and we're going to pasteurize these eggs.
I don't know what this is, but it looks okay, like
ice. Okay, so what cream. You're going to need to do, hold on, just set this in here, I'll tell them. What you're going to need to do is you're going to get you some whole milk. Get you a can of evaporated milk and go ahead and pour it in there with your whole milk. And then put you some whole milk in there, some real vanilla flavoring. Put you about a tablespoon of real vanilla flavoring. Then get you four eggs. And you're going to put you four eggs in a bowl. And you're going to put your thumb in there. Okay? It's going to be a clean thumb. You're going to put 2 cups of sugar. And about 3 cups of milk, 4 cups of milk in here. Show them what that looks like in there. And you're going to bring that to a slow boil. And then you're going to get your sous chef. This boy right here, we named him Sue.
I don't know why my daddy named me Sue.
Toughen you up, boy. It's Little Bob Sue Goat. All right. He'll probably sue me for naming him Sue when he grows up. So what your sous chef's going to do is you're going to gently, just
slowly
put that in until you reach 138 to 140 degrees.
It's better that with a temp monitor.
Yeah, use a temp monitor, but when it gets to where I can't hold my thumb in there, I know it's 140 degrees. We're about 130 right now. So we're going to go ahead and get it on up. We just want to get it as hot as we can because we've got somebody that is with child. So we're going to make sure that these eggs are absolutely positively pasteurized or temped, as they call it in the chef business. But you want to stir them really good because you don't want to end up with scrambled eggs.
Yeah, scrambled eggs is not good.
Not good in ice cream. All right, one more here, and it will probably be almost hot enough, and then we'll go a little more. Go ahead and turn it up sideways and just pour.
I was about to do that.
There you go. Get a good one in there, and then I'll let you fill of it with your thumb. Just don't burn me. Oh, yeah, that's getting really hot there. All right, well, that I think it's about to cook the egg. All right, let's see.
After it's temped, it shouldn't cook.
Just a little bit more. What do you mean after it's temped, it shouldn't cook?
After it's tempered.
Oh, so this shouldn't harden up and cook? I guess you could bake it into a souffle. He knows more about cooking than I do. I learned from a bunch of old granny women and then a bunch of... Okay, that's going to be plenty hot enough because that's at least 160 degrees right there now. Now we're going to go ahead.
I was actually going to eat because you're done eating.
Well, we're just going to finish this up right here.
My food's getting cold.
But if you say that ain't going to, if that ain't going to do
anything.
No,
it shouldn't. Just pour a little bit in there to make sure.
I'm going to go ahead and finish pouring this in there if I can. And that way we will 100%.
Not too fast. Just in case it's not completely. And we might be doing this all wrong. But
no,
I remember.
It's right, trust us.
And from what I've looked up.
And from what I remember from the old days. We're going to have some of the best homemade ice cream ever made.
Now you can pour a little bit of that into the pan.
Now I'm gonna just go ahead and add this to my ice cream mixture here.
Can I try?
Yeah. Cause that's just egg and sugar there. Turn it towards your face and see what you say. How's that taste?
Tastes like a metal spoon.
Yeah, little Bob has been exposed to too many of those What is it that those chemtrails?
Oh yeah, it's definitely chemtrails.
Well, actually, the chemtrails is putting a lot of metal taste in a lot of people's mouth.
It's actually the dentist from the other people I've talked to.
That is some of the most amazing homemade ice cream that I have tasted since 1972. What's it doing? Where are you cooking it there?
Not doing anything.
Pretty good. The ones I make's got a little bit more in it. But there's a sauce over here to dip it in.
Speaking of.
That's what
oh yeah, they're cooked. They're done.
They are done?
They are done.
Our pizza pockets are done, ready to pull out. Yeah, here's the one little Bob made there.
Beautiful.
It is. Oh yeah.
That's the first time I ever made any type of dough.
What is the, where's dough. the
over here in the corner.
Back. There's one.
Bigger ones are over here.
Ooh. And there's Uncle Goat's pizza pockets. Da 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 da. Let's break one open and see how they are. Woo! They too hot. Wait, I got a fork. I got a knife.
Here's mine.
Ouch. Homemade pizza pockets right here.
Right now.
Right now. There we go. Bye-bye now.